And welcome back to coverage here of the MagicFest Online Season Finals. Marshall Sutcliffe with William Huey Jensen. It's top eight time, baby. We are ready to roll. Take a look at our bracket real quick. Simon and Riggleby are playing against each other on the top in the kind of aggro mirror that we've got. Kevin1212 versus Yellowhat, Doomenstein versus Jason Ferrant, and Law versus PVDDR. That's two Pro Tour champions fighting it out down there. We were going to try to start on Simon Gertsen, but he's on a 10-minute delay. So we want to, you know, get going. So we're going to start on Nassif. So we're going to start on Gabriel Nassif versus Kevin 1212. This is Jeskai Lukka versus Mono Red Aggro.
Law is Yvonne Flock, just to answer chat.
Yeah, even when one half of a matchup like this is aggro, the games can often be very quick. I mean, if the aggro player wins, the games often are very quick. And if the control player wins, sometimes the game is so out of reach so quickly, it's like, you know, kind of an awkward hand here for Nassif. He's on the play. It looks like both. Oh, he's down a five. All right.
With a shark typhoon and a shatter the sky. That is not going to get the job done here. You're going to need some serious help.
Well, the shatters is probably his best card. At least
it is.
He has shatter and three lands and a cycling card. But he needs some way to gain advantage. You know, the thing about control decks, you want to play lands every turn, and you also need to answer cards. So being low on resources is a major problem.
That's right. Scorch Spitter on the battlefield. Turn one here for Kevin 1212. And there's a Fervent Champion to add to the fray. So already a bunch of damage coming in here for Kevin. Down to 17 goes Nassif. Oh, and there's a light up the stage as well. He sees a couple of lands, though. Nassif finds Elspeth Conqueror's Death, which doesn't have many targets in the opposing deck. Though there are some decent ones. And there's Annex Hardened in the Ford. So that's a card that Nassif didn't want to see here as he's trying to line up a Shatter of the Sky. At least he gets the Shark Typhoon away, the Scorch Spitter here.
I guess, but it gets replaced by the 1-1 from Annex. The good news is if he draws a land and plays the Shatter, you know, the Annex only give one token because the token left from Annex won't affect the devotion. Mm-hmm. So one token from Annex and one from the champion instead of potentially two from Annex and, you know, two from the other creatures.
And yes, that is a baby shark, Chad. You get your you got your baby. Rough start here for Gabriel Nassif. Did find the land. So a couple of Satyr tokens is all that's left over after Shatter the Sky. Wipes the board. Land number four now for Kevin. Obosh potentially next turn. Looks like just two.
So far.
It's best case scenario for Nassif. A spitter, and there's an Aether Gust.
I mean, he doesn't have any choice except for passing the turn.
Mm-hmm. With a land here from Kevin, can put Obosh on the stack. That would force... There we go. The Aether Gust.
Now this is tricky. I mean... Nassif looks like he's about to snap Gust it, but I think he needs to consider gusting the Scorch Splitter and hoping to just draw his fifth land and conquer that Obosh. Because if he just takes four here and then draws a land, like he kind of can't do much again. I guess he can then like make a token. Yep.
And he finds the same line that you just described here, Huey. So Scorch Splitter is going to get sent packing.
Like, basically what he's saying is, like, you know, if I don't draw a land here or some relevant way to interact, I probably lose, and that's okay. I'm going to need a land to win this game. I think, you know, he mulligan a five. You got to take a risky line. And
there's not a land.
Kind he kind of smirks at it. Like, oh, okay, yeah.
Yeah, I did hit the land. By the way, the Scorch Spitter got put on the bottom of the library there from Kevin. Nassif considering the option perhaps of cycling the Triome? Is that
for what though? I mean,
right. I think he just wants to land.
The thing is, he just dead? He takes eight. He just dies, right? If he just goes Triome pass. But what can he draw if he cycles it? Like, is he just dead to the Castle Activation? Because he'll take eight from Obosh and four, right?
Yeah.
So
he'll take eight and eight.
No, because Obosh doesn't double the evens, or does it?
Maybe it doesn't. No, you're right. You're right.
Yeah.
But still, it's eight, nine.
It's still lethal, but I think it.
Well, Nassif can hold things up here. Yeah, tokens are even mana cost, but they still get +1/+0 from the castle. So plenty enough to get the job done. And really rough start there for Nassif. Mulligan getting to five. Found the Shatter of the Sky, like you said, probably best card in the matchup for Nassif, but it certainly wasn't enough there. Now Nassif's going to go through and make some big changes. Take a look at the deck list here from...
So he gets Nassif. A lot of cards. He gets the Solar Blaze. He gets the Dream Trawler. He gets the two Clarions and the three Gusts. He gets to maybe trim on some like Elspeth Conquers Death. I would imagine an Agent.
So one interesting thing that we've seen is the players have been actually just taking out their agents and leaning on Dream Trawler. But I wonder if that's not the plan here for Nassif, is he just has the one Dream Trawler in the board.
And yeah, also that sure.
plan hasn't been working. But
has it not?
Well, on camera, it's, you know, anecdotal, but.
Sure. No, that's fine. I don't know. Like, the Agent of Treachery against the all 1/1 deck is kind of lame, right?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's not truly all 1/1s, but, you know.
Yeah, no.
Sure, maybe you jack the Obosh once in a while, but, like, mm-hmm. You know, I don't know that that's what I'd want to rely on. Another, like, semi-awkward hand for Nassif, like a definite keep, but, you know, this Omen of the Sea has to do a lot of work here.
Yeah, for sure. And this deck effectively always has a one drop ready to go on turn one. They're very dense on ones. As you know, Obosh means you can only play odd converted mana costs, so it's even heavier towards the one and three end of the spectrum. And here comes Grim Initiate getting in there. And see what the follow-up is here for Kevin. It's a light up the stage. Did hit some lands. And another Grim Initiate. So all told, sure, you've got two power. The Sea fires off this Omen of the Sea, but as you mentioned, very important. There's a land that he definitely needs. And
yeah,
he
but
can't cast a Omen.
Yeah, he's got a...
Ooh, well, now it, got there. So interesting decision point here. Shark Typhoon doesn't look great. It only makes a baby shark, which is a chump lock on these Grim Initiates. There is Omen of the Sun, but unfortunately, best case there is to trade off for one of the initiates by double blocking and still leaving your opponent with a creature to replace it.
Yeah, though you keep one of yours too, right? So you can trade off over two turns with one of the initiates.
True. And you get the little mini life bump, a couple of life in the bank there. Sacred Foundry, of course, a potential issue here as well, as Fires of Invention could be a card that Nassif is interested in, but that may require a tapped, untapped Sacred Foundry at some point. So he's going to dodge that bullet here and just leave up Aether Gust and the ability to just cycle Shark Typhoon if he'd like.
Yeah, he'll play Aether Gust here, I think, because his plan is most likely to play Fires of Invention and Omen next turn.
Mm.
I'm pretty sure that the answer to your question is yes. Two Obosh's would do quad damage.
So Aethergust finds a nice one here. Annex Hardened in the Forge means that Nassif's only taking two damage this turn. That has to be one of the better outcomes. And there's Fires of Invention. And we'll likely see the Omen of the Sun, though. With an Omen of the Sea drawn, it does give Nassif an option here. And yeah, it looks like he wants to keep going and hit these lands.
I think maybe keep the castle, but not the birth.
Hmm.
Like, the Yorion next turn is so strong, right?
Yeah. Yeah, like, if your worst case is to go, like, Omen of the Sun, Yorion, like...
Like, Omen of the Sun, Yorion, bounce three omens, yeah. And then either make a 1-1 or just make a 3-3 and draw a card.
It's awesome.
Yeah.
Okay, there's Annex coming down again, as well as the Grim Initiate. Boy, oh, Shatter the Sky.
Hmm. Yeah, but Shatter the Sky against Annex and Grim Initiate, it's unclear if there's,
you know. It's literally triple Grim Initiate. Wait, yeah. He would have more creatures if
he would have six creatures, I guess, with, but they'd all be even.
It's true. It would make land Obosh a lot more tolerable next turn. But that being said, there is also just the Castle Embrith on the battlefield, which wouldn't hate to see that many creatures. All right, there's Omen. Back up to 17 plus the 2 1-1s. And are we going to see Yorion here? There it goes.
I think so. I mean, gives two more 1-1s plus two cards.
Mm-hmm. A lot of selection as well. Pretty nice. Gets rid of the Fires of Invention for now as well. And that'll open up the door for a shark. I guess you can do that anyway. So here comes back three omens on the battlefield. So this is four omens hitting the battlefield in one turn. And a second sweeper is seen on top of the library with Solar Blaze.
Seems doesn't like want it. Nassif should have exiled Fires. I mean, it's nitpicky, but exile Fires and then draw your cards. I guess it doesn't matter. Never mind. I was thinking you could draw your cards before Fires came back, but it doesn't work like that.
Okay, there's Lukka in hand now as well with plenty of 1-1s. But, you know, this is a chance to see Yorion just be a 4-5, right? You mentioned this before that there's times when they just play the Yorion and it's like, oh, yeah, you just had access to a pretty decent creature. And that's what Yorion looks like here.
Yeah, and I mean, what can the opponent do?
Right.
Like, play a Bosh, okay. Right, like...
Right.
NX gets jump blocked by 1-1.
All right, well, it looks like the Grim Initiates are going to hit the red zone here.
This is supposed to represent, like, a lava coil or something?
Yeah, I do wonder if... How expendable Yorion is to Nassif. I feel like Yorion's done a good job already. So no double block on the Grim Initiate with any of the tokens. Just going to go for the big kids. And this certainly helps Nassif's plan with that Shatter the Sky. Just any of these... Anytime you can get things down on tokens, down to just tokens, it can mean the Shadow of the Sky actually clears the board. But here comes some tokens. We saw the Shock finish off the Shark. And there's Chandra.
Yeah, okay, that makes sense. Gonna try to get something going. Seif gets to get a Dream Dweller or Agent this turn, though.
Interestingly, he won't know which, right?
I couldn't see exactly how he ended up. Mm. Given that he has an agent in his hand, it's possible.
Mm. If a couple were trimmed or whatever.
Yeah.
All right, here comes Lukka. So let's see what Nassif hits here. There's no bad hits, and it's a Dream Trawler. So if this thing gets to stick around, Nassif is in full business mode here. I guess we're just going to send Annex Harden and the Forge back to hand.
Sure.
That's the case.
Maybe attack the Chandra.
Yeah, Nassif, and I was just going to say Nassif in fantastic shape. And Kevin1212 agrees. He's going to go ahead and scoop him up. Big smile from Nassif, as he is wont to do. And we just got to get a game three here on the draw. What's the worst thing that could happen?
Was that rhetorical?
Yeah.
Okay.
But yeah, you gave him Nassif, you know, you gave him the play, gave him a seven card hand, and he was able to sort that one out. Sideboarded cards in there don't hurt. So yeah, he's down to one Dream Trawler and two agents, it looks
right.
like.
Right.
Yeah, he's got a Solar Blaze, three Shatters, two Clarions. A lot of ways to wipe the board.
Does Obosh deal double damage to itself off of Solar Blades, or is it...
I think it has to, yeah.
No, I mean, it might be one of those cards that's like... two creatures or permanents. Yeah, it's...
What is it? How does it read?
The source you control with an odd-converted mana cost would deal damage to a permanent or player. Yeah, so it does. Sometimes it's like... I think the 7-mana, the Angrath's Marauders or whatever, was only to your opponent's stuff, but I could be wrong even.
Gotcha.
This is a kind of a rough hand. I mean, Nassif has a 2-mana card, Omen of the Forge, which can kill a creature, but he has to take 2 to play it on curve. And then he has Fires of Invention with no lands. I mean, with no action, all lands.
This looks like one to send back to me.
I don't know. I think I would keep it and try to get there.
Ugh. Need a lot to go right here.
Do you, though?
I mean, the Omen of the Forge kills 1/1/1.
Or a 2-2, if there were any.
I don't think there are. Fires doesn't currently cast anything.
I mean, I agree with keep and lose. I'm not like, I'm not jumping for joy here. I guess this is better.
Yeah. Yeah, Deafening Clarion certainly could help.
Put back planes and roll with it, or do you put back fires? I think too. No, please, Papa Hat.
Hat, please. An act of cowardice from Gabriel. All right, there's Temple of Epiphany.
I would not have bought him that either.
Yeah, I'm interested to see that he quickly put that one on the bottom where he does want to hit his fourth land and maybe even his fifth at this point. And he needs another red mana source if Luka's going to be part of the equation. In the meantime, rock and roll from Kevin1212. This is exactly what the deck's supposed to do.
Wow, that's a perfect card. You know why? You know why he's so happy? Because his hand was set up in a way where he just couldn't beat Anax before. Like, if this was an Anax into Nassif's Clarion, it's like sort of the same thing as last time. Anax, Clarion, oh, I had four creatures. Well, guess how many I have now? I have five, you know.
Yeah. And so, now he can get rid of both champions just cleanly with the Deafening Clarion, even if there's an Anax.
Right. And, I mean, it's also, if Kevin doesn't do anything, Nassif can do. Is Papa Hat the smartest person on Earth? Definitely top 10 said.
And there it is.
Yep. So now,
and now he can clear it away.
Clarion.
Yep. Yeah, two champions, and just leave you with a little 1/1.
And then now he has fires into Teferi, bounce Anax next turn, which is obscene tempo here.
down to 9. Here comes Annex Harden in the Forge, which, as you mentioned, that's kind of exactly what Nassif wants to see here.
Right, and now next turn, Nassif has set up for Shock with Steam Vents, make a 1-1, Lukka minus, get something.
Yep.
2-1 favorite to be an agent.
Solar Blaze was the draw there, and that means if it is land into Obosh, he has the answer for that, too. Ooh, Nassif. Who knew? You peel the ether gust off of your 80 card starting library, and things go pretty well for you. All right, light up the stage.
Another light up the stage, another one, and an annex.
All right, not bad.
I would have just lit it up again. I'm too greedy, I guess.
And just try to hit the land into annex.
Yeah,
I would too. Nassif dropping down to a precarious life total of 6, but that gives him the 1-1 token. Fires lets him cast Lukka. Lukka into Dream Trawler, or, as you mentioned, 2-1 that it's actually an agent, and it is an agent. Now, is it land or annex that you steal? Land would prevent Obosh.
Annex, yeah.
But annex is the onboard play.
Annex is...
Oh, you get a land too?
Yeah. Annex is large and in charge here.
Yeah. Somehow Annex is bigger on the Nassif side.
Yeah, and it's not even close.
Right. Unbelievable. The turns that you can do with Fires of Invention and Yorion. That is just such an absurd turn. Because even after all of that nonsense, he ended up with Planeswalkers somehow at higher loyalty than they were before. Oh, man. Cedric says ring the bell. He's done.
No shame in being beaten by the best, you know?
Yeah. That is
Get rid of Annex with Lukka. Really? Let's go. Synergy, Papa Hat. Oh, like he's deep in the tank. He's like, what do I want to do now?
Yeah. What should I do? Unreal. There are two copies of this mono-red Obosh deck in our top 8 here, though it does look like it's going to be tough for Kevin1212 to get out of this nonsense mess, and perhaps Nassif could move on to the semis. We're not done yet. He is down to 6 life, but the Obosh deck, not heavy on burn spells. They play, you know, there's a shock here or there, but it's not really what the name of the game is. Let's see if we can hit that Dream ET. Oh, there it is. Dream Trawler. And you know what? Let's just get the other agent on the battlefield too. Why not? Sacrifice the annex? Or does it exile it? It exiles it. Bummer.
Well, I thought it was a combo, but I guess it's not a non... I guess it's a non-bow.
Yeah.
He asked if we like... Papa Hat's mulligan. I said I would probably keep and lose, but I thought it was close. What do you think, Reed?
And for the record, I liked the mulligan.
I said you have 5 lands and a 2-mana card against this red deck and a fires, and I would just hope to draw what I need.
And there we go. Gabriel Nassif advances to the semifinals, defeating mono-red Obosh in impressive fashion there.